There are secrets known only to fundraising professionals, but I'm willing to share those secrets with you now. There are 10 secrets used by fundraising professionals, and I'm sharing those with you today. Secret number one, write your letter or email as if you were writing to one person. People love to open letters that are personal and private. It makes the donor or partner feel special and appreciated by the writer. Even if you're unable to use a personalized mail merge format such as Dear Joe or Dear Mary, having something designed for an individual like Dear Friend is so much better than Dear Friends. Secret number two, focus on motivations. What is it that motivates people to give to your organization? That is best explained through stating the problem that exists in society that your organization was created to address. Poverty, homelessness, clean water, human trafficking are all examples of problems that need a solution and needs the funding to make a difference in our world, to make things better for one or more humans. Secret number three, describe the nature of your work. What's your organization doing specifically to help solve the problem or address the symptoms or circumstances related to the problem? And be as specific as possible by highlighting the strategies, programs, and techniques you use to address the problem. Step by step works best if you can keep it succinct. And if they are unique to your organization, be sure to feature that in the forefront to make your plans stand out over those of other similar organizations. Secret number four, define the opportunity or need. Make it very clear what you're needing from them, and I mean more than just their financial gift. What can and will their gift be used to purchase or produce? And again, be as specific as possible. For example, your gift of X dollars today will allow us to provide a meal for a homeless person at Christmas. Or example, provide a Welcome to America kit for a refugee coming from another country. One meal of turkey, stuffing, yams, and beans will cost $10 and will provide a nourishing meal for someone in need. Always use a specific example of a person who has the need or a person whose need was met in the past by your organization. And be sure to use the name of that person or a pseudonym. Secret number five, address how the need is being met. Using the prior example for providing a meal to a homeless person, it's important to outline your plan to get the meal to the person. Do you have a homeless shelter? Will meals be provided for them there? Will people come to a location to pick up those meals? Either way, it's important to address how the need is being met. Secret number six, getting the reader to be involved in the solution. Show how they can be the hero of the story. They can make a difference in the life of even one person. And use the name of that person you used as an example above. You can either say, for example, your gift in the past helped Mordecai in his time of need, or your gift in the future will help people like Mordecai in his time of need. People want to be the hero in stories and save the life of someone from a rare disease or change the life of someone whose circumstances have not been the best. And their gift will change those circumstances. Secret number seven, show that you have widespread support. Do you have a track record of success in your efforts? Are you achieving your annual goals and overall mission, vision, and values? In this case, are you providing meals for those in need? Or do you work with government or other agencies to get the meals to people in need? If this is a repeat program or effort, highlight the successes from the past and use that as a springboard for the future. Last year, we provided 1,000 meals for homeless in the Kansas City area, and we'd like to provide 2,000 meals this year, but we can only do so with your help. Those are great examples. Secret number 8, show what can be accomplished with their gift. Link the gift to a specific purchase that can be made by their gift today. Continuing to use our example of a meal provided to a homeless person for $10, your gift of $100 will provide one meal for 10 homeless people. That's a great example. Secret number 9, promise a reward, result, or return on investment to the partner. Everyone wants to see their money used wisely and is making a difference. If you can include an outcome for their gift, do so. For example, your gift of $50 will feed a family of 5 this Christmas. And it's important to include the outcomes, as some people just see giving as an emotional, special gift during the holidays, while others see this as a wise investment of their donation or gift at year end or anytime throughout the year. Secret number 10. Focus on asking for the gift and including a deadline if possible. Make sure your appeal is very direct and straightforward. Your help at this time will make a difference. And specifically asking for a gift will really, really make things different and make it unique. But the best way to ask is very specific and to the point. Will you consider a gift of $100? $250 or $500 to help make a difference in the life of someone like Mordecai, who is in desperate need of a home-cooked meal? And if you are able to include a deadline in your letter, it's always best. Your gift by December 24 will make a difference, as we hope to provide a meal for those in need on Christmas Day. In conclusion, including all these elements increases the likelihood that your letter will be read, will keep the reader's attention, and will move them to act through a special gift at this time. Your year-end letter or any appeal letter can be greatly improved and produce more income for you and your organization. Do it right. Do it now. If you found this video helpful, let me know by giving it a thumbs up. And if you wish to watch future videos on this channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button and click the bell to be notified immediately of the next release. Also, post a comment below if there are things you especially liked or there are topics you'd like me to address. For videos similar to this, check out the video that I've included above. To watch other videos related to nonprofit fundraising, go to my channel, Development Effectiveness Strategies. And always, I wish you the best as you strive to increase your income and reach the goal of becoming fully funded. Thank you.